It can glue wood, stone, glass, vinyl, steel, lots of stuff in a very quick succession. Okay, so the base, it's not about review of this one. Review is that I have to buy, keep on buying every few months, and it comes in like the volume of this one was about like 40 ml or something, and all of them got destroyed because this is the old one. And what happened here, that as you can see at the bottom of it, I did not use all of them, and it got like, you know, completely dried out and screwed it up. I can't use it at all. Means it, once it dried out, I can't use it. And why it happens, because at the top they give you this nozzle to take the glue out, but this light, then what will happen if you put the cap on, and if you leave it in a container like a storage area, after a few weeks it will get dried out. Sometimes it does last for a few months, but every few months I have to buy the new one. So after that, I cut it open also, as you can see here, and try to see if I can get anything out of it. And it's expensive, actually. It's not cheap. I think 40 bucks or something. So today I'm gonna show what I'm gonna do to cure this problem. I think it's a manufacturer problem. They should come up with some more better idea how to airtight it. So this is the old one. This is the new one now. I have other one in my hand now. This is the new one, and on top of it you can see a big hole. And what you see right now, the red color, is nothing but
Play-Doh.
And this is the Play-Doh, as you can see here, and they are available all over Walmart, dollar store, any kids play section area. Okay, and so you just like take it off, and the Play-Doh can be of any color, you know. They are just like some kind of polymer, and they can come be of very color. So what I do here now is taking out this stuff, making a small ball out of it. And you can use a similar kind of a structure in the future, as long as it doesn't dry out, you know. So Play-Doh, I have seen, it really doesn't dry out that easily, you know. It is a very good material from whatever they have made it. Okay, and so I'm gonna,
it can dry out.
Okay, it can dry out, but if you leave it to open air, but not under a cap. So I'm gonna show now. So why don't you guys are talking to me, so why don't you take a video? Go and take a video.
Oh, sure. Give it to me.
Okay. Okay, here. So see, this is the opening here. What I'm doing is just like putting on top of it, okay? And it has to be bigger enough to like really cover, and let it...
Come on, you're not showing them.
Okay. Just like cover it up all the way, okay? Play-Doh is so easy to mold around. And you can use a similar kind of a structure. Maybe clay also should work.
But clay dries up.
Clay does dry out easily.
Molding clay doesn't. Molding clay.
Clay may not, but molding clay is expensive.
Okay? Oh, come on.
Play-Doh is not expensive, okay? And this is the cap here, and it can be used for similar project for any other things. So I'm gonna put it on and see what will happen. So I'm just tightening it out now. So what I'm doing here is just, yeah, write it, and whatever Play-Doh is left out, you can take it out.
Give me the Play-Doh. Where is the Play-Doh?
I'll give it to you. I won't keep it. Okay. So now you can watertight. Airtight, I'm sorry. This is really airtight now. I'm pretty much sure I can use it even a year later. Nothing is gonna happen. Of course, the Play-Doh inside will get bad, which I don't care, because I can use a new Play-Doh.
Oh no.
They are relatively easy to come out. The Play-Doh goes back there, okay? So that's the project, guys. End of the video now. Enjoy.